Okay. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Witcher 2 in the Claws of Madness. I need to go... this way? Yeah, this way. Need to go this way. Yeah, I need to go this way. Technically, yeah, this is... I don't know if this is a contract. But find the ruined hospital. That's my task. I don't know how this is gonna go, but... yeah, maybe I should... quick save. Yeah, so I just need to... ow. 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 Put the sword away. Don't know how this is gonna go, but we are going for it. Wait, what was that? Oh, shit.
Somehow, finally, I thought I was done for.
What's wrong?
I'm fine, but my friend remains in that damned hospital.
Cedric told me that two people went missing near the burnt mansion.
I'm Rupert Brandhuber. I'm a medic from Edder, and I came here with a friend to look for a very rare species of herbs.
These woods aren't the best place for herb making.
So we were warned, but the temptation was too great. We got as far as the site of the fire. No sign of herbs, but... there was something downstairs. Something. What's that? Can you hear it? That's Grimley's dog. Feel that? Something approaches. Help us!
Ow.
Thank you.
Oh, for goodness sake, I died. Right. I know I die, I'm not down to want to die, but the truth can be annoying sometimes. Technically, yeah, it is going to be annoying. I got some quests that I need to do, but not gotta do all this again.
Guess I'll never learn.
Yeah, I'm just gonna skip the conversation that we had with the guy, because, yeah, and I'm gonna, like, save as soon as I get into the...
Monsters.
say. Well, I literally don't have to basically climb back down there, because I'm going to be in there. In that new manor room. So, yeah. Basically, I could do, I don't know. I should have just boom, 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 backed away. I just need to, like, stay away. And, yeah.
How many more can there be?
Well, technically I died again, which technically I died, and yeah, I'm just, it's not my fault, it's just how I play the game.
Innocence, and I... How many more can there be?
It's creeping towards me. Lee! Leave me be! Away with you!
Control yourself.
It's not my fault. It wasn't me, not me.
What's not your fault?
Fire. Fire everywhere. It wasn't meant to happen. I didn't want that, I swear.
Won't get much out of you until I calm you down. Maybe the fire didn't consume everything. Maybe I can find some medicine, a sedative.
No way!
Help!
Easy. Rupert asked me to find you.
Rupert? Yves.
Listen, you and your friend. I don't get it yet, but you aren't telling the truth. That's painfully apparent. This place seems to have a very dark past, one you had a hand in. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Great. So now you can tell me the story and don't skip a thing.
Story?
There's always a story, Gridley. Spit it out.
We're former soldiers, fought for Eden during one of the wars with Nilfgaard, times long past. I was Rupert's adjutant in the field hospital that our unit set up in this manor house. We didn't at all mind who lived here. In fact, the inmates were friendly. At the outset, that is. One day our scouts captured a Nilfgaardian. He was desperate to win his freedom and claimed he was part of a detachment that had concealed the booty looted in Eden. We couldn't believe our fortune. Thought the gods had smiled upon us. We'd heard incredible tales of this treasure, questioned any black one we'd captured. It seemed all our efforts would finally be rewarded. We decided to make him talk.
By torturing him?
Our commander wanted to break him on the wheel, but Rupert said he knew a better way. There's a local herb. If you brew and drink it, you can only tell the truth. The commander interrogated the prisoner, drawing a map in the process. And we celebrated. Talked of how we would divide the treasure. And took ever greater liberties with the patients. The priest looking after them began to protest. And one of our boys split his head open.
Nice, Quickly. Keep talking and I just might let you go alive and intact. What happened next?
Once the prisoner revealed where the treasure was hidden, the commander had him quartered in front of the lunatics. They'd shown signs of madness before. When they smelled blood, well, we could not control them. Many we simply had to cut down. I don't even know how the fire broke out.
Any of the patients survive?
A young woman we managed to pull from the burning building. She was nice, quiet, and willing. 2 nights later, she slit our commander's throat, and that was all we saw of her, and of the map, of course. The war was ongoing, and shifting fronts forced us to abandon our search for her soon after.
And here you are, back after many years. Really think you can still find her around here?
Life's not treated me well since then, and Rupert's had it even worse. This is our chance to reverse our fortunes. Fate smiled upon us once. Perhaps by some strange chance, it still holds us in favor.
I wouldn't count on that. I think we're dealing with one heavy curse here. And it looks like we need to start by finding that Nilfgaardian's corpse.
All right!
What do you want, Spectre? Their deaths?
2 of 20 return when none remain. Yet one shall judge them. If he is merciful, he will feed them to the dead. If he is cruel, he will grant them what they came for.
A prophecy. I should have expected as much.
Bring me their hearts, so I may feast on their cowardice. Bring me their eyes, so I may spit in them before they are forever extinguished.
Is that your offer? Fine. I'll lift this curse one way or another.
No way! I pray. Help! Give me, Spinister!
enough Guardian's ghost. Let's find your comrade.
Gridley, you live. What happened down there?
I found the ghost of the Emperor's soldier.
You're the Witcher. Get rid of it.
The ghost wants you dead.
The ghost wants revenge. It brought you here to the scene of the crime. It'll lift the curse in return for you.
By the gods, you'll not help him, will you?
The ghost wants your hearts and your eyes.
Gods, you must trick him. Surely you know a way.
I can pull the hearts out of some neckers. Thing is, I'm wondering if it's worth it.
Witcher, I beg you. Do what you must. Go see the butcher for some pig's eyes and hearts. Anything. You'll not send us to a cruel death.
Pig hearts? I suppose there'd be some poetic justice in that.
Okay, so now I need to get the eye and heart of the necker or buy those oxen from the butcher and thrust them.
Damn, you're ugly.
Thank you. Hungry? Have fresh meat from some piglets I slaughtered yesterday. There's also some beef and some venison from the elves. You'll not find better meat for miles.
I need 2 pig hearts and 2 pairs of eyes.
What do you need those for?
For the needy and hungry.
Oh, right. Not my concern. Folks say all kinds of things about witches, but I expect you know that already.
Yeah, and most of what they say is true.
Aye. 2 hearts and 2 pairs of eyes. I needn't know anything more.
Alright, now I got the item heart, 2 of the item hearts. I mean, I could basically buy both of them. Alright, so now I need to go back outside. Back here again. So
you'll swear an oath. Once I give you what I've brought, you'll release your hold on this place.
Not so fast, Witcher.
I want a pact. I want you to swear on this curse. Then keep your word, or your lust for revenge will go unsatisfied forever.
I'll trust you. Let shadows withdraw into darkness. Let madness be soothed. Let what has died be buried. Let this place that was cursed be so no more. Now, give me what you brought. Fool, who knows not that the dead cannot be deceived? You sought to rob me of my revenge. Dog, you shall share the fate of those thieves.
Now that I killed the thing that's basically be in this place, I would see that it's no more. Okay.
I destroyed the Nilfgaardian soldier's ghost.
Thank you, Witcher.
You have to be You have to be punished.
I've lifted the curse, but the perpetrators must be punished.
What are you going to do?
I'll take you to Lurido. Let him pass judgment.
No, not him. Just not him. We'll not go anywhere.
Shut up.
Halt! Who you got there?
Murderers. Lurido needs to judge them.
Get out of here. Look at him acting like a constable.
Guests? How nice. Bring him to me. We should talk about the good old days.
In the claws of madness. Alright guys, if you guys have enjoyed this episode, please like and comment and subscribe. I know this is the longest episode I've ever done, but, you know, it's one of those things. Anyway, thanks for watching. Remember to hit that red button or subscribe button. I'll give you 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Have you subscribed? Now you are. Now you're welcome to my channel. If you haven't already, go and hit that notification bell. It tells you when I'm whenever I upload my videos. So, yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. Anyway, bye-bye. This is gonna take forever.